Hello, welcome back to Destiny. I've just installed patch 1.08. I'm going to have a bit of a look around and see what's changed, what's slightly different, what's not. So when everything gets landed, I will have a bit of a look around and see where we are, what can be altered, and yeah, go from there. So thankfully the loading times on this game are not as punishing as others that are out there at the minute, newly released for the PS4. At least they're slightly entertaining. Right. We're going to Mr. Titan Man, the guy that sells the gear. Because apparently, the Vanguard vendors sell upgrade materials, as do the Crucible ones. So we're going to go to the Titan Chappie. Well, he doesn't sell crap.
Travelers need help.
Okay. Mr. Shaxi, what have you got?
Let's see what you've got. Let's get to it. Catch you later.
Yeah, what gifts?
Yeah. Go.
And there they are. Ooh, crystal marks, 10. That's not bad. 10 marks for 20 upgrade. That's pretty cool, actually. That's very cool. I like that. Okay, let's have a look. See what we've got. It's been a while since I did some PvP on this. I think the last time I actually did some PvP on this was during the Iron Banner when they brought out... actually during Iron Banner when I was doing Rumble to get access to my fusion rifle bounty, which has gone a little bit nuts. Right, let's have a look at this one. It's 10 marks. Given that I don't need any more Vanguard marks and it's pretty much just going to get poured into these weapons, that is very cool. So whenever you need any upgrade materials, just pop in here, because, well, to be honest, if you're just upgrading one little thing, you're looking at 16 max for one upgrade. So
the Vanguard has a great many supplies.
That'll take care of it, and you can get what, five, even if you just do the daily, you're looking at 2 days. That's not long. Let's go to Dead Orbit Man.
Shall we get started, Guardian?
Okay, nothing much has changed with him either. So he's still selling stuff. Right, next thing is upgradable stuff such as exotics. Thankfully, I've not fully upgraded this. because I was holding off, because at this point it had got so as I had the 3 left over. But as they've just changed it, these 3 have gone from requiring upgrade materials, such as the shards, to just requiring the exotic shard, the new thing that's out. So that's kind of cool. It's made things slightly easier on the upgradable materials, which is fantastic. So let's have a look. We've got... shards and energies. So let's have a look. Armamentarium. So you're looking at 950, 250. There's the cost. Glimmer. 1,500. So yeah, you get that back. So your materials to upgrade. Exotic shards. It's not Ascendant energy anymore. Ascendant material, Ascendant shards. We get on to the exotic weapons. The only one I've got is Super Good Advice, which has now got substantially improved, apparently. Doesn't require energy, just requires a shard. One shard is 7 strange coins. Just FYI. So, something to put your weekly stuff into. When for the last 3 weeks that he's popped up, he's had the armamentarium, void fang vestments, and a changeable hunter chest, and that's it. There's been no difference in the gear that is sold. The only thing that's changed has been the weapon. Suros, about 3 weeks ago. I've not seen Icebreaker for a good couple of weeks. That's pretty much the big change that's come around with this. It's just the reduction in the Ascendant materials for doing that. Now, also, the other great thing that they've done, and I really do appreciate them doing this as well, is when you run your daily, irrespective of what level you run the daily at, you're going to get upgrade materials, which is great. So there's no point in having a look around the tower anymore because we've done everything. So let's just come on, load up. There we go. Right. So how you say you're now going around the cosmodrome, you pick up spin metal. You're going around the moon, you pick up helium. You go around Venus, you get spirit bloom. You do the daily, you get spirit bloom, 10 of it. So let's just have a look and see if it scales. It does, it scales, fantastic. So doing the level 8 is gonna get you 16. Doing the level 24 is gonna get you 10. Doing the level 20 is gonna get you 10. So like everything else, it scales up. The harder you do, the more you get. Except, of course, for the Vanguard marks, it's still 5. So get some mates, do the level 28 version, get that done for there, and yeah, you'll be done. Nice and easy. Right, so set the destination, back to the tower. So yeah, it's all good. Anyway, that's patch 1.08. So they've upgraded some of the exotic weapons too. Increase the base damage for some of them, but they've kind of balanced out some of the big effects that they've got in the weapons, which is kind of useful. So your exotics for the additional effects will probably be no stronger than the raid drop weapons, but there are some other differences that you're going to find. But other than that, that's a really cool thing that they've done. They've added the upgrade materials to your daily mission, which is really cool. So you get 10 for doing minimum 10 for doing the daily, plus if you can really stock up in a couple of days, you can have at least 30 minimum. Probably looking close to 40 upgrade materials in 2 days, which is more than enough to take care of any weapon. Well, halfway to take care of a piece of gear. More probably not enough to take care of a weapon, but definitely go halfway on a suit, that's for sure. So upgrade materials are definitely going to start getting easier to get if you're running multiple characters. If you're not, then still might be kind of tough. Let's have a look. So you're looking at 20 and 12, so 15. Yeah, you could be sitting at close to 40 marks, or 45 every couple of days, if you're prepared to put your Vanguard marks into that stuff. I would possibly hold off, because with a DLC coming out very soon, which is pretty much what this upgrade has been for, we might be seeing more purchasable Vanguard gear dropping. We don't know what. Well, I don't know. The devs do, but there might be some boosted Vanguard gear for us to get at some point. They did that in DCUO. They may not do that here, but as the raid goes up to level 32, I'm not sure if it starts at 30 or if it goes up to 32. But yeah. Anyway, that's pretty much it for this. So I will catch you next time with more stuff from either Assassin's Creed or Destiny. It's pretty much where I'm living at the minute. And I'll get back to you in a bit. So thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in a bit. Bye.